It is not every day that you get an opportunity to felicitate somebody publicly. And when you do get that opportunity to go out on stage and appreciate somebody through a speech, then you want to make sure that you make the most of that opportunity. Everyone, welcome back to the English Web. I am Bhagyashree. In today's video, I shall be taking you all through the steps involved in giving a felicitation speech. Now, when do you give a felicitation speech? When somebody is being honored, awarded, or acknowledged in public view, you know, some achievement or milestone that is being celebrated. Either somebody is retiring or somebody is getting awarded for a breakthrough achievement, among many other things that, you know, one must have done through his or her career. It is very important to note that there is no particular order in which you give a felicitation speech. So there is no right and wrong when it comes to giving a felicitation speech. The order of the steps is totally upon you, but I particularly like to use the format that I will be sharing in this video because it resonates with how I would like to felicitate somebody and how I would like to show my gratitude. Let's look at the steps that are involved when it comes to giving a felicitation speech. The first step is introducing the honoree. Just try and introduce the honoree in 2 to 3 sentences. Do not give the name right away. Try and let the reputation precede, their names. So if somebody is, say, a teacher and you want to talk about, you know, their achievements, start by talking about those before you actually come down to sharing the name. So that is the first step, just introduce the honoree. The second step is talking about how thankful you are to get an opportunity to felicitate that person. So whoever it is that you are felicitating, it is important to acknowledge how thankful you are to get an opportunity to go out there, give a speech in full public view and tell people about how big an achievement that is in itself. And just show some gratitude out there to everybody around and especially to the honoree. The third step is talking about the hardships the honoree has gone through to get to where he or she is in his or her career. It is very important for people to know the journey of what that person has gone through before getting to where he or she is. It also builds that respect among all those who are not very well averse with the achievements of the honoree. So it is a very important step when it comes to felicitating somebody. The fourth step includes sharing your wishes for the honoree. So there is something you want to add a personal touch to your speech, you know, because you've been chosen to felicitate somebody. Make sure it's unique and typical to you, to your feelings, and just, you know, pour your heart out when it comes to wishing somebody. And if you want to share some interesting anecdotes or your experiences with the honoree, you can use them to link them with the wishes you are sharing. So if, for example, I want to wish a teacher who I am awarding, I can say that, you know, this teacher has changed and touched lives, including mine. And I can share an interesting anecdote when I was struggling, you know, with my academics, and this teacher really pushed me to my best. And as a result of that, I, you know, came out with flying colors and it changed my life completely. And what you wish for him or her, if that person is not retiring, you can say that, you know, I only wish that, you know, this teacher continues to touch lives and create such an impact in the lives of many other students. So something like that would make your speech all the more interesting. And the last step when it comes to felicitating somebody is by welcoming them. Now the honoree is yet not on stage. You know, you have just created that aura, you're building up that mystery before you welcome that person on stage. You know, you can kind of, you know, you can ask people to welcome that person amidst a huge round of applause. You take your speech to its peak before welcoming that person on stage. So yeah, that is your way of telling everybody how thankful you are and how important the person is who is getting acknowledged. Once again, the 5 steps that are included are: you introduce somebody, Now you don't necessarily need to add the name of the person or share the name of the person here. You can just use some interesting, you know, titles that they've been conferred with. Even if you want to share the name of the person, that's fine. It's totally up to you. Then the next step includes sharing how thankful you are to get an opportunity to felicitate that person. And the last step is welcoming him or her on stage. Do not forget to check out the sample felicitation speech in the description box below. And if you have any other questions, you can always address them in the comment section below. And do not forget to hit the like button if you like the video, and do share and subscribe to the English Web. I shall see you guys soon. Goodbye.